All right, so we're back, and in the previous video, we set up a way for our character blueprint to talk to our animation blueprint to determine if we are still punching. In this video, we're going to continue setting up our event graph of our animation blueprint to actually play our animation montage. Now, the other thing that I noticed in between videos here is that in the last video, kind of gave a general explanation of what casting is. And you may still be asking yourself, well, he explained it, but I'm still a little bit not clear on how it works and why I need to do it. So I kind of wanted to take a quick second to give you another example that has been thrown around the offices here, and I think it kind of resonates with people. So I am going to relay that information to you as well. So the best way to think about casting is, say if you take a action star, right? So think about somebody like Hugh Jackman. And Hugh Jackman plays the part of Wolverine. So Wolverine has claws, he can regenerate his health, he's huge, he has that crazy hair and so forth. Think about casting this way. If you cast Hugh Jackman as Wolverine, then Hugh Jackman becomes Wolverine. Suddenly Hugh Jackman has claws and he has, well, he always has that hair, but he has hair and he's big. And that's kind of what casting is. When you take something that are When you take two things that are of similar type, so you have Hugh Jackman, who's a human, he's kind of like a Wolverine type character, and you have Wolverine, who is obviously a Wolverine character. If you take those two and you cast Hugh Jackman as Wolverine, then he becomes Wolverine, and suddenly he can do all those things. What I wanted to point out is that you cannot take two things that are different and cast to them. So for example, if we had Try Get Pawn Owner here, and we wanted to cast this to, I don't know, a static mesh or a light or something like that, that's not going to work because we are only interested in pawns and, by extension, characters. So those are the only things that we can cast to. So I just wanted to take a quick second to kind of explain that again. Hopefully that helps clear it up a little bit more. But in essence, casting is a way to talk to between blueprints, to talk to, make sure that they are the things that they need to be talking to, and if they are, allowing you to access things inside that blueprint. So with all that out of the way, I guess we can continue inside of our event graph here. So what we're going to do, first thing that we're going to do actually, is off of our is punching, what we need to do is add a branch. So we're going to hold B on our keyboard and a left click to create a branch node. And we're going to connect the out of the set node into the branch. And then we're going to connect this pin here, which is the result, into our condition, like so. So what we are doing is checking if is punching is currently true or false. And the next thing that we're going to do, we need to create a custom event. Now, a custom event we can call off of our branch. And that custom event is going to actually play our animation montage. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's right-click and create a custom event. So you type in custom. There's the option to add custom event. So go ahead and select that. And it's going to ask for a name. We're just going to call it punch, like so. And off of punch, once we drag off this executable here, we can search for montage play. So you can see there's a couple different functions here. We only are focused on the montage play. That's going to play our montage. Now it's asking for a montage to play. Click the drop down here. We only have the one, so go ahead and select our punching montage. And there's also an option for in play rate. I kind of wanted to mention this as well. On this node, you can actually specify the play rate in which to play this montage. Currently, we're playing at the default value of one. If I hop over to the actual animation montage inside our animations folder here, if I open that up, I think I talked about it inside the when we were setting this montage up. Under the animation section in the anim asset details, there's the rate scale. This is that same value. We can change it here and increase our speed, say to like 1.5. So he's punching crazy fast like that. On second thought, that does look pretty cool. I'm going to keep that. You could set it here. Let me save that. Or you can set it inside the animation blueprint as well. So let's go back to our animation blueprint and our graph. You can set it here as well. And this will override whatever is set in the default setting. So with that, let's continue. What we need to do now, let's right click in the graph. And under the add anim notify event, If you recall, remember we set up those animation notifies to check whether or not we are still punching. We need to add both of these events here. So go ahead and add those. So select the first one here, is still punching one. And then right click and under add anim notify event, is still punching two. So these, if you recall, let's go back to our animation. I guess I can go here. Back to our animation tab really quickly inside of our punching montage. There are our notifies. So we are checking at the end of each punch if we are still punching. So back on our graph, what we're gonna do, let's hold B to create a branch to check. Let's create two branches actually because we're gonna need them. And connect our executables into the branch like so. Then down inside of our My Blueprint window here, let's take our is punching and just drag that and drop that on top of the condition. So it will connect it like so. And we can also take the other wire and plug it in to this one as well. So now it's checking the value of is punching. Are we still punching? If we are still punching, then we are going to automatically loop our punch one and punch two together. But if we are not punching, then we need to jump to the punch end sequence that corresponds to whatever punch that we just finished with. So is still punching one is our left punch, is still punching two is our right punch. So we need to tell our montage to jump to those sections. So let's do that. Let's right click on the graph. We're gonna search for montage set next section. So montage set next section. Go ahead and select that. And off the false, as we said, we want to connect that to our montage set node there. And it's asking for the section name to change. We want to change punch one. So enter in punch one here. And our next section is going to be punch end one. And then it's asking for the montage asset. So go ahead and select that as well. Like so. And we need to do the same thing for punch two. So I'm gonna copy this node, Control C, Control V, and I'm gonna hit connect the false, like so. And we're just gonna change the sections here. So we're gonna change this to punch two and punch end two. So hop up over to the toolbar, compile and save. And we are almost done. We need to actually call this custom event now. There's one thing that we need to do before we do that. If we right click and we say punch, search for punch. So we're looking to call the function punch, which is our custom event. If we connect this directly to the true right now, so is punching still true? Yes, we're still punching. So go ahead and play the punch montage, which will fire this. The problem with doing just this and this alone is that we are updating this every frame. So what's going to end up happening if we did it this way, it's going to run through this process, check and see if we are punching. It's going to set the variable inside our animation graph to our animation blueprint to punching. It's going to say that's true. So it's going to keep firing this event over and over and over again. So what's in essence going to happen, it's kind of similar to if you're on like a media player and you just kept hitting play and play and play over and over again, it would just keep restarting the montage over and over again. So we're going to have to add something before calling this custom event. This is actually going to be a pretty quick process here. So we're going to right click and we're going to search for a do once node. So under flow control, we're going to do once. And what we're going to do is off the true, connect that to our executable here, like so. And then connect the completed to our punch. So when we get to this point, it's going to say, is punching? Yes, it's true. Do whatever is following this node only one time. So we'll execute punch once and play this animation montage, which is what we want. Now, the problem with that is if we get to this point and is punching is false, we're currently not doing anything. Fortunately for us, we can connect this right to the reset of our do once. And what that will do is the next time that we come back to this node, we've reset it so that we can do whatever is following it again. So mouse button is held down. We get to this point. We start punching and we only do it once. We do this custom event once. When we release, it resets this node. So the next time that we come back in here, we can execute that sequence again. So with all of that, we are going to pause here. Let's compile and save really quickly, because there's one other thing that we need to do. We need to actually hop into our animation graph, which we'll do in the next video, and hook up our montage to our slot, which we talked about, and play a slot node. So we'll do that in the next video. We'll pause here, and we'll pick up in the next video and finish off setting up our punching montage. Thank you guys for tuning in, and we'll see you in the next video.